Building, securing, and operating distributed applications is difficult. While your application must always be secure, time spent on operations below the application level doesn't add unique value for your customers. In the next few minutes, you'll learn how serverless on AWS offers you the most secure way to build in the cloud, allowing you to focus your efforts on features that create customer value. The AWS shared responsibility model assigns responsibility for security of the cloud to AWS, while the customer remains responsible for security in the cloud. David Richardson, Vice President for Serverless at AWS, introduces the shared responsibility model and shows how responsibility for operations and security differs across various AWS compute services.
In AWS, we like to think about different levels of shared responsibility across the different building blocks that we provide. And so if you build your application on top of EC2, where we work very hard on the security of the hardware itself, you're going to own things from the operating system image and on up, and so have to be responsible for patching the OS, for patching the language runtime, the libraries that you support, that you use, and then building controls into your application so that it has the appropriate boundaries. On the other hand, if you start to use some of our higher layers, more opinionated services, if you will, we're able to take on more of those responsibilities on your behalf. And so with Lambda, we're able to take on the responsibility of not just secure hardware, but also patching and keeping up to date the operating system, the language runtime, the common libraries. And through our integration with identity and access management, where you make it so that it's easy for you to configure the right level of permissions for the individual capabilities of the Lambda function that you would like the rest of your system to depend upon.
It's important to remember that while building with serverless improves your application security posture, you still retain responsibility for application security. Listen as David explains how building with serverless reduces your operations and security workload, allowing your engineers to apply more effort to higher value tasks.
So one way you can think about it is when you're running in the cloud, there's both the responsibility for using the cloud in a secure way. This is where your work comes in terms of the code that you build and how you configure your use of AWS resources. And then there's the security of the cloud itself, which is our responsibility. And so with an approach like serverless, where we are able to take on a lot more of that responsibility on your behalf, you're really able to focus on writing secure code, which can be simple when it can be small and focused on individual tasks at a time, like in these standard architectural practices. You can think about it as it's usually a lot easier to understand the security attributes of a small, simple Lambda function than it is of a large, traditional, monolithic application. And we think that that fine-grain aspect makes it easier for you to accomplish better security, both because you have a greater chance at understanding the attributes of that small piece of code. It's pretty commonly believed that the smaller the code base, the fewer the bugs, or the more quickly they're understood. And then nicely, it also allows you to use capabilities such as identity and access management to make fine-grained access control, both to define, as you build out a richer microservice, which functions or which other aspects of a microservice are able to call each other, and to ensure that individual function or individual microservice can only access the data that it truly needs. And that's a lot easier to do than when you have a big monolithic piece of code, which may need access to many things. And so you wind up having just a larger, coarser grain security model than you could with finer capabilities.
By eliminating infrastructure, serverless eliminates entire categories of security issues. Charlie Bell, Senior Vice President for Utility Computing Services at AWS, discusses how leaders should think of security with serverless and some of the considerations you no longer have to manage when building with serverless.
So Charlie, how should leaders view security with serverless?
Well, first of all, it's like all the other things with infrastructure. If you don't have it, you don't have to worry about it. So if you servers, you have to worry about securing them. You have to make sure you don't have the misconfigured firewall running on that server. You have to make sure that you have all the proper access and permissions. You know who can SSH into the box. It goes on and on and on, all the things you have to worry about. But if you think about, like, take Lambda, for instance. So here you write the code that handles a single request. That's all it does. And it runs, we run it inside of a virtual machine. So it's well inside of no human access envelope. And so you've basically inherited all the security of the underlying environment, and you can't misconfigure it. You can't make a mistake. And so eliminating infrastructure eliminates opportunities to have security issues. It's a really important thing. And now, you still have to write good code. If you want, for example, you want to make sure you encrypt data. You want to make sure you have these functions properly controlled, the access controlled, which, we provide the ways to do that. But the surface area is so much smaller than you would have with traditional infrastructure that your security goes way up. Your security teams just have a much easier time of it.
Strong isolation between customer environments is a top priority for AWS. That's one reason we created Firecracker, an open source technology purpose-built for creating and managing secure multi-tenant services that provide serverless operational models. Here's David explaining how Firecracker uses virtualization to provide a level of isolation between environments that isn't possible with containers.
Now, while a lot of what we do is to try to take on a set of the responsibilities so you don't have to, and we make it easier for you to do the things that you have to do, like choosing who has access to functions, we also have invested a lot in innovating to provide greater security than we think is even possible in traditional environments. And a good example of that is our Firecracker virtualization system. We have long believed in Lambda that you need a level of isolation between customers that can only come through virtualization. Just using separate containers between customers, we felt, hasn't been a strong enough security boundary. Now, the unfortunate thing is it traditionally takes hundreds of seconds, minutes, to create and spin up new VMs, unlike in the container world, which can be hundreds of milliseconds. And we didn't like that quandary. We didn't like the fact that it was slower to spin things up with VMs, but the faster containers didn't provide the security boundary we liked. And so across AWS, we built a new technology called Firecracker that's intended to give the full, strong security isolation boundary of VMs, but with the agility and the low latency and low footprint of creating new instances that you can get with containers. And so we've launched this in open source because we think it's a critical thing for the industry. And we also want to ensure that those of you who have a trust but verify approach to security are able to go and look at the code and see how it works and test it and challenge it. And so what this means is, behind the scenes, whenever a new instance of a function is spun up because additional concurrency is needed to serve the incoming requests, we create a new Firecracker VM and launch and run the Lambda runtime, whichever managed language or custom runtime you choose, as well as your function code inside of that. And then we allow it to access your VPC depending upon your configuration. And so we continue to take strong isolation, strong protection of your function code as one of our top priorities.
With Firecracker, every function runs in its own virtual machine, providing isolation even between different functions in the same customer account. Adrian Cockcroft, Vice President for Cloud Architecture Strategy at AWS, shows a number of ways that Lambda functions running on Firecracker reduce attack surface even further, making serverless applications more secure than is even possible in traditional environments.
If you think about the way Lambda runs, every function is running in its own virtual machine. Put a little Firecracker logo next to the on the left there. We've rolled this out over the last year. We used to run all the Lambda functions for a particular customer in one virtual machine, and the functions could interfere with each other potentially. But now every individual Lambda function is running its own virtual machine, which is much more secure, but we have the new Firecracker system that gives you a very lightweight to do that. Because that it's a very minimal attack surface, that virtual machine is only running for a few hours before it's recycled. And the initialized Lambdas are only reused for the same account. And there are no open ports. There is no port that you can connect to get to a Lambda function. The only thing you can do is cause an event to arrive at that function. So the attack surface is much smaller.
You may be wondering how this enhanced security holds up when interacting with other services. What tools are available to ensure that serverless applications are running as intended? David returns to explain how networking and guardrails layer on additional security and deliver a risk-managed approach that allows you to balance time to market with risk to the business.
You know, along with these properties of the code itself is how you interact with networks and how you can use networks in building a layered set of security so that you can have minimal use of which services can talk to each other, minimal set of things that can talk to the public internet. And so all of these serverless systems are able to integrate into VPC and allow you to build a very custom network, you know, at whatever level is appropriate for your applications. You may have a relatively simple approach to network design for internal use applications that are just there for, you know, your employees or that don't cover sensitive data, and then a richer network architecture for either your applications that use highly sensitive data or that have to talk to the internet. And so you're able to define your VPC in whatever way, you know, best helps you with that. You can have it be a free-for-all where anybody can do whatever they want. And, you know, that can be chaotic, but that can also lead to a lot of innovation. And who knows, maybe in prototyping areas or internal applications, that's the appropriate choice. At the opposite extreme, you know, closest to that traditional approach can be a high degree of central control. That means the risk of making a mistake or at least of doing something against the typical desired approach is low, but usually it also has the most slowness and is the hardest to have rapid innovation. So one thing that we think is an interesting kind of balance between these two is a concept we call guardrails, where the idea is you want to be able to have some central definition of what those best practices are and ability to use set of tools to understand your compliance and enforce your compliance with that. But within that, give as much freedom as possible to application teams to be able to innovate and find the best way to build their application and use the sets of services that are available to them. So guardrails are mechanisms. They're practices, they're processes that reduce the occurrence and the size of the impact of undesirable application. And this is going to include both implementation techniques, things that can be built into the architecture and the use of services, as well as standard practices. And so it can be easiest to think about this at the security and compliance end. And that's where things like using Control Tower to establish standard sets of configurations for accounts can be helpful, and using IAM policies to define boundaries to ensure that while you may give flexibility to individual service teams or IAM principals and roles, you've set some limits to ensure, you know, for example, nobody can create a VPC on their own.
Guardrails are key to the security of applications at scale, making it easy for your organization to safely realize the benefits of a serverless architecture. Werner Vogels, Vice President and CTO at AWS, explains how to apply guardrails in your application.
Guardrails are an agreed-upon standard set of parameters that can be implemented for all kinds of actions. Guardrails can be set to define things like governance rules or provisioning limits, monitoring requirements, and other standard building blocks that are packaged as part of a deployment. Let's apply the concept of guardrails to a service-specific example. If your teams are using AWS Lambda, you could use Lambda layers to compose several standard layers in your own custom code into one function that complies with agreed-upon corporate rules. The AWS CDK is another tool that simplifies packaging configuration as code, making it easy for teams across your organization to pull from a central repository and then deploy with their application. These are just a couple of examples of guardrails in action. Determining and distributing guardrails makes it easy for your teams to operate within the boundaries you establish. It also makes it easy for teams across your organization to quickly and safely go serverless and fully realize the benefits that come with this approach. In a modern application context, operations thinking is as important as ever. It becomes more strategic and more impactful as it becomes less manual.
In this video, you've seen how serverless architectures on AWS provide the most secure way to build applications in the cloud. You discovered how serverless allows you to offload more responsibility to AWS and maximize the value that you deliver to your customers. You learned that Firecracker runs your code in lightweight micro VMs that combine the security and isolation properties of hardware virtualization with the speed and flexibility of containers. Finally, you gained some tools to help you layer on security and reduce blast radius with VPC networking and guardrails. At AWS, we believe that serverless offers greater security than is even possible in traditional environments. We hope you now feel the same, and we look forward to seeing what you build next.